Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. The Church of Jesus Christ presents Pastor and Evangelist Pete Rowe.
Praise the Lord. All right, children, I want to thank God and say greetings and welcome everybody back today to the program. We thank God, children, for this privilege of getting to be with you today. And we're going to be especially speaking now concerning the rising troubles and storms that's facing the world today. And truly, children, we as Christians today need to do a lot of good praying for America and the countries and all the turmoil and trouble that's facing the earth today. Now, this is just letting us know that the day of the Lord is strong at hand. And I believe it is definitely getting time where God's people need to look up and remember now we're coming to the closing of time. And that means that there's a final day of judgment and a time for the Lord to return to receive, not set up, but to receive His kingdom unto Himself. And then truly all the sufferings and pains and the conflicts and turmoils and troubles that's in this world, it's going to be over with. And thank God, God's people get a new heaven, a new earth, and then that'll be only the righteous. There'll be no more worries about the devil or sin abounding and all of this. But now, we definitely need to realize that we're in a time that it's going to take enduring and holding on to God even to the time of the end. And we're going to be letting you know, children, some of the perilous times it's upon you. And if ever we need to listen and heed the word of God and do like the good apostles begin to write, to contend for this faith that God had once given to the saints, which means strong believing and trusting in the word of God, we're going to have to do it because it's truly running out of time. And we appreciate the Lord want to welcome you. And I also want to invite you now to be sure you that get us by radio, but if you can't get us by cable and watch the programs by television, if you have an internet, no matter where you're at in the world, you can click on the website of Living Faith Television, and their website is www.livingfaithtv.com, and we have our programs on streaming video, and it comes on Tuesday through Saturdays at 7 o'clock. And of course, we're also on here in Lexington, Kentucky, and also on WYMT out of Hazard by television. And thank God for our radio program on WSGS that's out of Hazard also, WSGS FM. And we thank God for that station. I believe it's 101.1 on your radio dial. And so you in West Virginia, Tennessee, Kentucky, wherever you are today, you can receive our programs if you're tuned into the website of www.livingfaithtv.com Tuesday through Saturdays. And also on my website, I'm putting programs on them, and we're going to try to keep it more updated. And that's on www.pastorpeterowe.com, and we have our programs will be on them. And we got a lot of good anointed articles. It's definitely speaking on the last days and the times you're facing. So we invite you to tune in with us. We just appreciate the Lord and thank God we're seeing His power to save and His works being manifested. And also we invite you, we have our church service on Sundays at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and also on Wednesday and Saturday at 7 o'clock in the evening. We invite you to come out and be with us. And we're not a denomination or any kind of a form or whatever it's set up. We're just good believers in the Lord, and we want to represent the Lord's Word, and that's why we're trying to build ourselves upon the foundation of God's Word, because that's what it's going to take to stand in the evil day. So we appreciate you, and I want you to be sure now to have your Bible ready as I begin this message. And it'll probably take me a few messages in series, and I'll be speaking on the storms and troubles you're seeing happen right now. And believe me, if ever the Bible is a fulfilling, and you can see the Word of God abounding right over your television, your news medias, and see all the troubles it's facing us, these are what God called the signs of the times of the end. And believe me, they're here today. And I'm going to begin here in a few minutes out of the book of 2nd book of Timothy. And I believe it's about the 3rd chapter. But let me read you something that Jesus said to us here in the book of Matthew chapter 24, I believe it is. And I want to rehearse some more things that Jesus began to write to us. And if ever we need to understand when the Bible declares, and you can read a lot of places where God talked about iniquity not only abounding, but there were workers of iniquity. And a lot of people don't understand what that word iniquity means, but it does also mean lawlessness, but it also means that people that's claiming gifts, claiming signs and wonders and miracles and claiming to be this or that, and yet they're not really pleasing to God. Because we're going to be showing you here a few minutes out of Matthew 7 or in one of these programs. And children, we need to understand now that iniquity also means that people that's claiming to be Christians, but yet they're living a life of the world. And did you know the Bible teaches in James that a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways? And we can't serve God with this mind to want to serve Him one day, and then the next day you're out here playing around with the world. That's a lot like what Jesus said, or Paul did rather, about the days of Moses, when the Bible said they ate and drank of that spiritual rock that followed them, and that rock was Christ, but they begin to eat and drink and begin to rise up and play, which means they committed things that's worthy of death, and therefore God had to finally reject a lot of them. So children, it pays you to get on course and learn the Word of God and follow it. And if ever we need to crucify the flesh and the affections and lusts and things that hurt your relation with God, these things is going to have to happen, because the Lord is coming for a church that's without a spot and without a blemish. And children, it's not just talking, but it's becoming a doer that God's going to bless in His deeds. And I believe it without a doubt. Most people can see by the troubles and things that are happening that the power of God is being left out, especially in a lot of the churches, because the Bible said they have in a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. And He said, turn away from such. So we need to understand that we have to give the more earnest heed to the Word of God if we're going to make it. And we just thank God today. And I'm going to begin our message here out of the book of Matthew, if you got a Bible. And I just want to read a little bit here what Jesus begin to speak to the disciples now. This is in the book of Matthew, chapter 24. And I want you to notice what the Lord began to say here. And you read the whole thing when you get time. But in the book of Matthew, chapter 24, Jesus began to tell them in verse about 37, "But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be." What He's telling you, as Noah's day, what was going on in the days of Noah, it would be like this in the time that Jesus is to return. And you better believe you can see these things happening. Now watch. "They were eating and drinking, marrying, giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be." Now, this is what we're going to be speaking about. Let me just run you back here in the book of Genesis again and show you now a little bit about the days of Noah. And also, you can find about the days that it would be like in the days of Lot. See, these things is happening, children, upon this earth today. And if you'll turn with me to the book of Genesis, chapter 6 and about verse 1. Bible said, "It came to pass when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God, never said nothing about angels, but sons of God saw the daughters of men, that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose. And the Lord said, my spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh. See, he's speaking about men here, not angels. Yet his days shall be 120 years. There were giants in the earth in those days, and also after that, when the sons of God came in unto the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, the same became mighty men, which were of old, men of renown. Now listen to verse 5. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man, beast, creeping thing, fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah, thank God, found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man, perfect in his generation, and Noah walked with God. And Noah begot three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japhethah. Now listen to verse 11. The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. Now the Lord is the one that's seeing this. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt. See, children, you got all these laws trying to pass for legalizing same-sex marriage and legalizing a lot of things that would hinder the freedom of God's people to worship God. And this is bringing corruption upon this earth. But you know, if you'll notice, God said, listen, that he looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them. And God said, behold, I will destroy them with the earth. And then, of course, God goes on and tells him about building of the ark. Now, study this out, because God ended up allowing a flood just to destroy all flesh that was up on earth. But now God reserved the earth. This earth you're on right now has been reserved by God for everlasting punishment. And he said it's reserved against the day and perdition of ungodly men. Now, children, we're facing a time like it was in Noah's day, violence. You're seeing all of these things facing you. And also, I know I've taught on this before, but listen to Luke. I believe it's about the 17th chapter. And I want you to listen now what Jesus began to tell them also. He said in verse 26 concerning days like it was in Noah's day, and he said, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the days of the Son of Man. That, of course, that's your New Testament age. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage until, see, the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Then he said, likewise also, as it was in the days of Lot, they did eat, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they builded. But the same day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Now, children, that's what kind of condition your earth is getting in today. And I believe in